श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम सदा शिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशंकरं लोकशंकरं। तपोभिक्षीण पापानां शान्तानां वीतरागिणां मुमुक्षूणामपेक्ष्योऽयं आत्मबोधो विधीयते। सो फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव स्टॉप्ड यस्टरडे इन अ वेरी क्रिटिकल इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट वी सॉ two rules, I mean grammar rules, pertaining to 25th verse. When you say any verb is there, that verb has to depend, some ashraya is required. Like we saw example, Rama is walking, so Rama is ashraya for the verb gamanam, walking. Who is ashraya? Rama. So first point. Second point, grammar says that any action is there, ashraya is there. Without ashraya, karma is not possible. Second is that that ashraya must change because of action. That is the grammar rule. Like suppose somebody is Rama is walking. Who is ashraya? Rama. So there is a change in Rama. Position change, he is gasping, he is walking, he is getting tired. He may be losing energy. There is a change in him. So, in this, here now, janami is a kriya, process of knowing. When I know, jnana kriya, because knowing, there is a because of indriyas are there, mind is there, all of them are involved, there is a kriya is going on, jnana kriya. So because of that, I say aham janami. So in jnana kriya also, there must be ashraya. So aham janami. So aham janami in this vakya, I know. So knowing is the kriya. Here according to the grammar rules. Not shuddha atma. Shuddha atma, there is no kriya. That's what we will see now. So I know. So now, in this aham janami, the Purapakshi says, how can you say aham janami? When you say atma is nishkriya, changeless, when it is changeless, how can it say that I know? I know means something is happening inside you. So there is some change in you. So Shankaracharya says, this first of all, we must know how this knowing is possible. So therefore Shankaracharya says, this jnana kriya is also a superimposition. इन शुद्ध आत्मा द आत्मा आई एम से शुद्ध आत्मा ओनली फॉर क्लैरिटी पर्पस. सो इन आत्मा दट इज इन प्योर आत्मा देर इज नो ज्ञान क्रिया बिकॉज आत्मा इज शुद्ध ज्ञान स्वरूपम. देन हाउ कैन यू से अहम ज्ञानामि. हु इज दिस अहम विच इज नोइंग अहम जानामि. सो हाउ डू यू से आई नो. सो शंकराचार्य सेज दिस क्रिया ज्ञान क्रिया एंटायर थिंग इज दिस व्हाट श्लोक सेज नाउ 25th श्लोक. दिस एंटायर ज्ञान क्रिया इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन द माइंड. सो व्हेन यू से आई नो जानामि आई नो. So the actual process and all is happening in the mind, in the antakkarana. And that kriya is what? Kriya is happening in the mind and it is a vritti vikara. It is a modification of thought that something is happening inside. Vritti vikara. So now, so what is kriya? Kriya or action, nothing but a thought is moving in the mind. Thought modification in the mind. In the mind. Now what is that? We will see now. What is happening to Atma then? Shuddha Atma? Nothing is happening there. Atma is simple Jnana Swarupa. It is just there. All whatever is happening, everything is happening only in the mind, in the Antakkarana. Shuddha Chaitanyam is not there. He is just watching. But what is happening is, in the vritti vikaras, in thought modifications, which are taking place in the mind, the Shuddha Atma reflects. So therefore, because the Shuddha Atma Chaitanyam is reflected, the Chaitanyam aspect of Atma is transferred to mind by reflection. Like the electricity is transferred to bulb. So then we say bulb is glowing. Glowing is a kriya, for example. Shining. Bulb is, or fan you take for example, more important. So the fan is moving. It's a kriya. Gamanam. Similarly, when Shuddha Atma reflects in the mind, in the vritti, the manovikara, that is Chaitanyam aspect of Atma Chaitanyam reflects in the mind. So therefore, one is Atma, second is the reflection of Atma, third is vikara of the mind. So reflection plus the modification of the mind together by joining these manovikara and the Shuddha Chaitanyam reflected in the mind together, we make a statement aham janami. So something is jana, aham janami is happening in the mind, antakkarana. Because Atma is never be jnata. Because there is nothing for Atman to know objectively. Therefore, here Acharya Shankaracharya says, if you see the textbook now, Atmanaha Sat Chid Amshascha Buddhehe Vrittihi Iti Dvayam. Good. So Atma has got Sat and Chit Amshaha. Sat aspect. That is pure existence. Chit is consciousness. So sat aspect and chit aspect of Shuddha Atma is reflecting in the antakkarana or vritti. So this Atma which has got sadamsha and chidamsha And buddhi has got what? Buddhehe vrittihi. Buddhi has got vritti. Buddhi has got a thought. Thought form. Ghatakara vritti, patakara vritti, vrikshakara vritti. Whatever the vastu is, tad vastu, tad akara vritti. So vritti is shaped according to the object that it perceives. Therefore, the tadakara vritti. One side. So buddhi has got vritti aspect, modification. Okay. Then what happens? Moment the vritti comes. Moment the vritti comes, vritti is formed. The chaitanyam, atma chaitanyam, it reflects, no? So sad and chit aspects of the shuddha atma pervades the vritti. Because vritti is there, formed, atma is there, atma reflects, and that reflected atma chaitanyam pervades the vritti. So vritti is borrowing the atma chaitanyam. Okay. So sat aspect and chid aspect of the vritti is, vritti contains two. One is modification and the reflection of consciousness. So sat aspect and chit aspect are bought from atma, number one. Vritti supplies the vikaram, modification is from vritti only. Therefore, vritti gives us vikara, atma gives in sattanchit. So joining both, dvayam, these two. Buddhi vikara and shuddha atma, sat amsha, chid amsha, these two joining, dvayam samyojya. See the textbook if you have text. So, atmanaha, sat amshaha, chid amshascha, plus buddhehe vrittihi, iti dvayam samyojya, these two joining together. Where are the joining? In antakkarana. When they join together, there, ignorant person, avivekena, janami iti pravartate. So an ignorant person says, oh, I know. Which I know, this ahankara, the vrittyatmaka. Shuddha atma doesn't know. It is merely witnessing. It is not jnata. It is jnana swarupaha. So beautiful. So therefore, jnani will not say, aham janami. For vyavahara, I may say, I know. But in fact, the understanding is what? Aham asuddha atma na kinchidapi na janami. I know nothing. I don't know anything. But there is nothing to illumine me. Because I am jnana swarupaha asmi. Who am I? I am the sakshi of all the vrittis. I am not the subject of change at all. I am changeless. So, beautiful. So, Bhagavan Shankaracharya, he doesn't give any example for this shloka. But we can add one example. Shastra example is there. Aya pindaha. Aya agni pindaha. Red hot iron ball. We normally we say iron ball burns. Red hot iron ball. In this, what is happening? In fact, iron nature is coolness. Iron is svabhavataha. Not hot. Agni has no shape. It has not a specific shape. So, and also, so what does it do? Agni gives its burning power to the iron ball. Think. And iron ball shapes the Agni and appears as though Agni is round at that time. So when the ball and fire are mixed together, it creates an illusion that iron ball is created. So these two are mixed in Antakkarana. Reflection of Atma Chaitanyam and Vritti. So the Vritti pervaded by the Atma Chaitanyam. Fire pervading the iron ball. Beautiful. So the answer is what? Who is then knowing Aham Janami? Shuddha Atma is not knowing. Shuddha Atma doesn't know. So who says Aham Janami? So answer is Chidabhasa Vishishta Antakkaranam Janati. The Chidabhasa is there, no? Reflection of consciousness in Buddhi. That is ego. That is I. There the sense of I-ness is born. Little I. So identified with the Vritti, illumining its own Vritti, it says, Aham Janami. Who is not Janami? Aham Janami. Aham means what here? Chidabhasa, Antakkarana conditioned consciousness, expressing as I, little I, knows all the thoughts which are there in the mind. It illumines and claims, I know. Think. Therefore, in worldly language, somebody says, I know maths, I know physics, I know chemistry, I know this, I know that. You are considered as a wise man with respect to worldly knowledge. But in Vedantic knowledge, if you say, Upanishad says, if you say, I know, then you don't know. Because it cannot be known. When you say Atma, I know Atma, that means you don't know Atma. Because Atman can never be known as an object of anything, as an object of perception or knowledge. So this Sabhasa Antakkaranam, Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkaranam is called as Ahankaraha. That Ahankaraha, not Shuddhaham, that Ahankaraha claims that I know. Shuddhaham na janati. Now here what important? Kevala buddhi janati va na. Even the buddhi has no capacity to know without the touch of the consciousness, without the reflection of consciousness in buddhi. Buddhi cannot know on its own. Why? Buddhi is inert. Shuddha Atma also doesn't know, because Atma Chaitanyam is Shuddha Jnana Swarupaha. That is why it is called Agatana Gatana Patiyasi Maya. Who is saying, knowing, knower, knower, that samsari is only a fictitious entity that will come in Panchadashi. We are studying Dvaita Viveka now in Panchadashi. So in the coming classes of Panchadashi, Vijayaranjamuni defines, who is this Jiva? Technically, who is called Jiva? That is coming. I think in the first class only it will come. So friends, now see, read the sloka. Atmanaha, of the self, satamshaha plus chidamshaha, sat aspect, existence, and consciousness aspect, plus buddhe vrittihe, and the vritti aspect of buddhi. Both cannot know, but it's called what? Chit jadak grandhi. Something, it is like a reflected consciousness falling in the vritti, and buddhi suddenly becomes awake, and the chidabhasa, that is antakkarana, which is conditioning the chidabhasa, that knows. So these two dvayam samyojya, there when these two are joined together, vritti and atma tattva, reflected consciousness, when they join, then avivekena janami iti pravartate. So there the fictitious entity is born and he says, I know. That's why Ramana Maharshi says, inquire, who is this I? You know, when we inquire who is this I, that I disappears. I is a fictitious entity. Ahankara is a fictitious entity. It's a maya. But for me, it is right now, I feel I am there. So I feel it is there. That is called. So then now, who is knowing? Na, Shuddha Atma knows, na Buddhi knows. Buddhi is inert, it cannot know. Shuddha Atma need not know anything, it is full in itself. It is Jnana Swarupa. But these two come together. And there the fictitious entity is born. And says, I know. So friends, this is how Bhagavan Shankara is a question. Who am I? Question, who am I? Continuing, 26th verse. Atmano vikriya nasti buddher bhodo na jatviti. Jivasarvamalam jnatva jnate jnata drashteti mukhyati atmano vikriya nasti buddher bhodo na jatviti jivasarvamalam jnatva jnata drashteti mukhyati. Very, very beautiful verse. Now, he says, neither Atma is the knower, nor Anatma is the knower. As I just now said, what is Anatma? Buddhi. Neither pure Atma is the knower, nor Buddhi is the knower. Atmano vikriya nasti, buddher bhodo na jatvati. So Atma cannot be a knower. Why? If it has to know, then it has to do the kriya of knowing, jnana kriya. If Atma is knowing and jnana kriya is there, that means Atma is a locus of action, ashraya, karma ashraya. That means Atma is savikari. We said second point, if the locus of action is there, the locus of action subjected to change. So if Atma is a locus of action, then Atma is Savikari, it becomes changing. It starts changing. Savikari. Atma is Savikari. And since Atma is what actually, essentially what is Atma, sir? It is essentially Nirvikari. Atma cannot be a knower. So Atmanaha Vikriya Nasti. Atma does not have any modification. That means Atma cannot be the knower. Therefore, Atma na jnata bhavati. Anytime the Shuddha Atma na jnata bhavati. It just illumines. Then can't we say Buddhi is knowing everything? Buddhi may be jnata bhavati? No. Buddhehe bhodaha na jatu api. Buddhi bhodam is chaitanyam, a consciousness here. Buddhi has not got that consciousness. Jatu api means kadachid, never. At any time, Buddhi has not got the capacity to know. because inert matter cannot know. It has to have consciousness, and buddhi has no consciousness. Buddhi by itself is inert. Buddhi does not have chaitanyam in it. Okay. So consciousness cannot know because it is changeless. Matter, buddhi cannot know because it is inert. And still somebody says, I know. Who is this? Says somebody says, I know. This is a very beautiful inquiry. This is the highest spiritual sadhana. See, Ramana Maharshi, what he did, he just cut the root of samsara. You know, for everything, Mola Karanam is I only. So we want to protect this I. Protecting the I, keeping the I safe. Ego safe, individual entity safe. I want to be happy, I want to be eternally happy, I want name, I want fame, I want health, I don't want to die, I want a good wife or husband or children, house, car, wealth, prosperity. And because of this, I only all problems are coming. Since I consider myself as ego as so real, solid entity, I think all the samsara around me is real. Remove this I, there is no samsara. It just collapses. Like in deep sleep state, the ego resolves, no samsara. The individuality remains in. But mind is not there, buddhi is not there, no samsara. So what is that to which this samsara belongs? This is I. So in meditation, in inquiry, like Ramana Maharshi gave this beautiful sadhana. So in the name of sadhana, many of us, what do? We are strengthening this I, ego. Please listen carefully. By desiring many things in life, by strengthening this I think I am well better off. So many sadhanas I do to protect this eye. I want to go to Swarga. You know, all desires. Or who is a desirer? The desirer himself is a myth. So janami, aham, karomi, bhunjami. You go into meditation. Inquire, who is this I? Therefore, it says, Jivaha Sarvamalam Jnatva. So, this Jivaha, he knows because of conditioned by these things, Jnata Drashta Iti Muhyati. So jiva actually doesn't know that atma is avikari, buddhi is jadam. Because buddhi is inert, atma is avikari, no modification in atma. So without this knowledge, jivaha jnatva jnata drashta iti muhyati. He only knows, he thinks that I am real. I am doing, I am thinking, I am acting, I am enjoying. Aham karta, aham bhokta. These limited things only he come to know. And doesn't know that atma is avikari. So jnata, drashta, I am knower, I am the seer, iti muhyati. This jiva deludes. So therefore this entity which is called I, when you inquire this I, all the samsara which is sticking to I, is sticking to I, foundation is I. All idam vrittis are depending on aham vritti. The aham vritti dissolved. All idam vrittis also will go away. And what remains is you, the real you, shuddha aham. So far you have been considering, I am the ego. Identification. When ego is dissolved, then I shine in my own glory. Atma shines. Very beautiful thought in these two slokas we saw. Next one, 27. Rajju sarpavadatmanam jivam jnatva bhayam vahet. Naham jiva paratmeti jnatascet nirbhayo bhavet. Rajju sarpavadatmanam jivam jnatva bhayam vahet. Naham jiva paratmeti jnatamce nirbhayo bhavet. So here, so what is the original nature of Atma? It is not Jnata, knower. It is not Karta, doer. It is not Bhokta, enjoyer. Chidabhasa Vishishta Chaitanyam Ahankaraha is jnata, bhokta, karta. Therefore, I am shuddha jnana swarupam. In that pure self of me, I superimpose the jnatratvam, knower, sense of knower, knowership. It is actually, I am not in me, this is only an ego. But I superimpose that sense of knowership on me and I consider that tasmadeva samsara bhayaha. So for it says, jivam jnatva, jivatmanam jnatva, jivam jnatva. Jivam means that, you know, rajju sarpavad atmanam jivam jnatva bhayam vahet. Like Rajju Sarpa. Like Rajju Sarpa, the snake and the rope. Considering the rope as snake, then what it comes? When I consider the rope as snake, it is producing bhayam, fear. beautiful thing. So when I consider as Shuddha Jnana Swarupam, no bhayam. When I come down to Jnata level, I think I am a Jnata, Bhokta, Karta, then bhayam comes. Just as rope is seen, no bhayam. But snake is seen, rope is considered a snake, then all kinds of fears come. Beautiful, no? So he says in Vedanta, what if when you become Jnata, when you understand that, you know, I superimpose the ego on me, or Jnata, Jnatratvam on the self, the knowership on you, the pure self, then the moment you become knower, the Triputi will come, what something is to be known. So Jnata, Jnayam and Jnanam, relationship between the knower and the known, the knowing, Triputi comes. Pramata, Pramana, Prameya, Karta, Karanam, Karyam, all the things will come, Triputis will come. Because I am there, when the moment you bring I, then I want to know there is something, I become knower. Knower means something that is known, and there is a relationship between known and the knower, knowing process, Triputi has come. And once a Jnata becomes something, then I want to know something, I don't want to know something. See, the sansara begins. So I want this, I don't want that. So pravritti nivritti. Dvividohi vedo margaha. Vedokta margaha. Shankaracharya says in Gita Bhashya. Dvividohi vedokta margaha. Veda marga is only two, pravritti and nivritti. Either you go towards the world, or you go within yourself and realize the truth. Only two margas. Inside to out, or go inner side, go outside to inside and realize the truth. Pravritti, Nivritti. And once you are in Pravritti, then Punya Papa will come. Punya Papa will come. Nivritti. Suppose you are doing Nivritti from the dharma, then papa will come. What is to be done? You are withdrawn because you are individual, then punya papa will attack you. They will start. When punya papa comes, then the karma is increasing. Agami karma, sanchita karma, prarabdha karma. Then to bhoga karma, we have to take physical bodies. So every janma we take, thus samsara begins. This is called samsara bhayam. So therefore, when I slip myself as an ego, as an entity, as an individual, and to protect the individuality, I struggle a lot to make that ego stronger, happier. Only I do karmakanda, I do upasana. Uddesha is very important. Intention is important. Intention is only for antakkarana shuddhi, thereby Vedanta sadhana, and thereby realization is my goal. Fine. But I do karma, suppose most of us do, I do karma only to enjoy the result, and then that result is not satisfying me completely. To modify then another karma I do. While doing such karma, I may do some mistakes. And the mistakes, whatever I done mistakes, I have to suffer for those mistakes, bad karma. Thus, I am chakki pe pise ja raha hu. So, if Shuddha Jnana Swarupam is known as Jnata, samsara bhayam comes. If the rope is known as snake, the fear comes. If rope is known as rope, no fear. Nirbhayam. Naham jivaha paratma iti jnatascet. So if you know come to know who you are. I am not Jiva. I am not the reflected entity. I am not Chidabhasa. I have been identified with it so far. Now I have to start the reverse process of detoxification. So I give up all my false entities, false eyes, individuality, and its various expressions. Na aham jivaha, then who are you? Paratma iti. I am Shuddha Jnana Swarupaha, not Karta, Bhokta, Jnata, etc. Jnataschet, if you are really understood, if you realize in this way, Nirbhayo Bhave, there is no bhayam. There is no marana bhayam. Friends, you know, really we become fearless only when we established ourselves in Advaita Jnana. Nakinchid antaram kurute atha tatra bhayam bhavati. If you take little bit of difference you create in between you and something other, sense of otherness creates fear. If I recognize all is me alone in my sadhana, if I recognize, then there is no sense of otherness. Then there is no fear. That is how great Mahatmas of this country, they never bothered if somebody showed talwar, a knife, showed to them, I will cut off your head. The masters used to smile. You may separate my head from the body, my dear, but I am not this body. You can never destroy me. I am that supreme. So, very beautifully brought out by Shankaracharya ji, samsara bhayam is only because of our falling down from our original state of Advaita Sthiti to a lower state, Sansari, Jnata, Karta, Bhokta, then Punya, then Papa, then Palabhoga, then Karma result, then Sanchitam, Agami, then Karma Shuddhi, then modifications in Karma to get some other results. Thus we are strengthening our I. Is ego. Life after life, we are strengthening our ego. Even in spirituality, we think we are spiritual. But in that spirituality also, I am attached to one path. I am attached to one thing. The following one guru, one text, one marga, one mantra, that is a different issue. But stating that alone is correct, everything else is false, that is attachment. That is another moha. My path alone is correct, your path is wrong, another moha. That is attachment. You are strengthening individuality. My mantra is superior to your mantra. My deity is superior to your deity. Now somebody says, suppose somebody comes and tells you, I read Bhagavad Gita, and you have not read Bhagavad Gita. Suppose you read Ramayana. Suppose. You don't say that, okay, I have not read Bhagavad Gita, I think I have to read, sir, thank you for reminding. We don't say that way. What do we say that, वो तो ठीक है, आपने रामायण पढ़ी? Because I read Ramayana. So, what I want to prove, I know something which you don't know. In this garva, in this ego, I am deriving a satisfaction that I know something than the other person, even without acknowledging that he read something without my knowledge, without means he read something which I don't know. I did not acknowledge, simply I did not acknowledge it. I can acknowledge, yes sir, I don't know, I never read Bhagavad Gita, I think I have to read. If you have read, you can help me also, suggesting me good commentaries or good teachers. So, even in the spirituality also, unknowingly, because unknowingly means I don't say we are unaware. We think we are seekers, but we are strengthening our ego, most of us. Genuine seekers are there, those who are dissolving their egos, not giving any room for their ego to grow. So such seekers we have to prostrate. But most of us are also caught up in this kind of thoughts. Somebody glorifies their guru and you have your guru. So you can listen to that guru, glory of that guru also, no problem. You can listen and you can praise, okay, yes, very great Mahatma, one of the best expression of reality, my namaskarams to him. Instead of that, then I bring glory of my guru and I try to prove how my guru is unique than your guru. In this entire kind of hodgepodge which we are creating in the name of spiritual sadhana in the field, we are actually strengthening our ego, individuality. Therefore, I have to rise above holding on to Shastra, Guru Upadesha. As Ramana Maharshi said, dissolve this ego by inquiring. Because it can't stand to inquiry. Ego cannot stand to inquiry. So that is how Bhagavan Shankaracharya is leading us. So tomorrow we'll start 28th verse. Okay. Thank you very much. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Arihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Arihi Om Sat Gurunath Maharaj Ki Jai. Thank you. Hari Om.